Hello, dissenters, and welcome back to Slime Rancher. We're taking care of all of our phosphor slimes in the cave now that they are not slowly disappearing anymore, because they have plenty of plorts for us to take and sell to start upgrading our ranch. I want to get everything self-sustaining. I want to have just a constant supply of food going into the bellies of the slimes and plorts being vacuumed up nice and neat, ready for us to take to the exchange. Let's get started with these beautiful phosphor slimes and go from there. They are just chowing down a feast of Q-berries out here. So happy and glowing. Look at all the plorts that we're gonna be able to take back and turn in for money. I need every single one at this point. We're running so broke right now. My goal, really, ultimately, is to set up a self-sustaining ranch where we can just pop in from time to time, gather the new food that has been growing and the new plorts, turn them in, and start actually raking in the dough, because right now I feel like I'm constantly just trying to fight to stay above 1,000. And also, something else that's been fixed is I can no longer shoot excess Q-berries into growing from the tree because they're still gonna grow. So I haven't figured that out. I guess maybe once the tree disappears is when you need to replant them, because right now you can't do it. But we're just gonna leave some more of these Q-berries out here because they're apparently still hungry. All of those plorts were just the first course. These are basically hobbit slimes. We've had first breakfast, Etalyx, but what about second breakfast? 1, 2, 3, 10, 30 phosphor plorts. We're gonna be rich. Hang on, are they worth good money right now? 2 green arrows up. Sell them all. 30 in a row because we got that expanded capacity upgrade. How great is that? So that's 50% extra carrying capacity in every slot. That just makes things so much easier now. And since we've got these excess Q-berries, what do I want to do with them? Put them in the feeder, perhaps, for the Largos? That actually does make a lot of sense. So let's put most of them in here, and we'll save, like, say, 6, just to toss in here from a safe distance. Oh, gosh! They just shot that right back out of me. No, you eat it, Etalyx. No, you. And I bet they get extra excited when they get fed as well. And probably started exploding even more. Whoa, what? Oh, what? Hang on. Can someone explain how that just happened? You saw that, right? Did the explosion, like, shove them through? Like, phase them through the wall? It is getting just a little bit cramped in here, though. A bit more so than the Rock Tabby Largo. And, oh, you know why that is? It's because we just fed a bunch of these, and all of the boom slimes are feasting on the plorts, and they're transforming too. So this has just gotten really crazy and out of hand, despite having the music box and everything. Oh, did you see that? They just burst through the top like a volcano. Now I gotta clean this mess up, put them back in the kennel. There's just too many of them in there. There's too many explosions happening. I have severely underestimated their ability to break through that cage. This is just getting a little nuts. The ceiling cannot recharge. Okay, well, we're gonna have to do things a little bit differently here, aren't we? We're gonna have to put a few of these in another cage, and we're going to have to build up an air net. It's about time we got an air net over here anyway. There's just plorts hanging out, an explosion trying to kill me all at the same time. Come with me. We gotta move these guys over. There is currently an emergency going on. Hopefully the net has a little bit more time to recharge now. I guess the color of it is indicative of how damaged it is. Like, that one just turned red, and now they're jumping out again. These guys are troublemakers. Just complete troublemakers. Meanwhile, over at the peaceful, calm pond. Whoa, oh yes! You guys have been busy, haven't you? Yeah, we're full, aren't we? We gotta go make some sales. I'm getting stuck in the pond myself. Let's see how much money this gives us. We got a bunch of rocks, a few tabbies, and 1 honey. But this is not a good time to sell, certainly not for these plorts. So I guess that's one thing that we could maybe use the storage unit for. If I really wanted to maximize money, we could, like, add another storage unit here, perhaps. I don't know if I want to yet. And then put plorts in there just for the sake of waiting until we can actually sell high. Oh dear. Oh no. I accidentally created monsters. What have I done? We've got a true emergency going on now. I just killed all of the slimes in this cage. I don't know what to do. They're all gonna start bouncing around. Okay, okay. Hang on. Be calm, Etalyx. We gotta shoot them off the edge. Yes, we gotta keep them out of the other cage. They've all got nets on top, so that's good. That's good. Just don't let them get to the pond. Hang on. Don't eat all of my slimes, please. We gotta shoot him away. I have made a grave error, and I'm sure some of you were probably yelling at me, but that is the fun. That's the fun, isn't it? Is trying to do the science and actually, like, messing up makes the game not feel so easy anymore. So we're taking all of our huge tar slimes, trying to keep them from eating all of the population. Oh, they're consuming everything. The death of the ranch is upon us. They're getting everywhere. Please, don't let them eat all of the huge Largo slimes. I don't care about the tabbies. We can get more tabbies. We can get more. We just gotta get these last couple out. They can eat through the cage. They can just reach their arm through one side and eat the slimes. That doesn't seem fair at all. Where's the rest of them? Is there one more still hanging out over here? Get the honey back in. If nothing else, I've got great aim. Not one of those tar slimes missed the slime sea. That feels like a little overpowered that I can access the slime sea from that point on. But I guess the damage has already been done, hasn't it? At least our tabby largos are okay, and these honeyboom largos are okay. I don't know what I was thinking. Putting all those together, I should have known what was gonna happen. But they're the only ones who suffered. Just a few rock slimes, no big deal. We still got honey plorts, which are gonna be really good, actually, to mix up with some rock slimes because they both consume vegetables. That's good. We're gonna start using... Yeah, I had to clear this out anyways, guys. Right, yeah, that's exactly what I was planning. Let's get back on track now. That was a disaster, but we'll pull through it as we always do. We still have plenty of slimes here to feed and take care of. Speaking of feeding, I believe it is high time we get an auto feeder at all locations. I've got a fresh harvest of heartbeats that I've taken from the supply that you may have forgotten about, actually, over in our first expansion. Not the cave, but the big field where we've got some pink plorts still roaming. Load this up with 17 heartbeats for now, kind of let it do its own thing. And what do you guys need? Fruit and meat, is that so? Okay, so we'll put a few cue berries in here, since that's what we've got. Don't you do that to me in hen hens! For the tabbies, because they do love meat. Now, we could feed meat also to these, and probably get better plorts overall, right? Okay, so we'll give 5 hen hens inside this enclosure, and then the stony hens can go to the tabbies. I just feel bad. I know 4 chickens isn't quite enough, but it's the best we can do. I think we need some more chicken farms. Well, we still got 3 whole plots over in our first expansion. I'm just a bit worried that all the pink slimes over there are going to be able to get over this wall, even the high wall variant. So I'm gonna take a little supply of each type of hen. We seem to have a pretty good stock over here. And let's go experiment. I'm gonna try. We can always make more. I didn't take all of my roostro's hens or stony hens. We haven't shown you this place in a long time, have we? There's where all the heartbeats grow, and look, plorts litter the landscape. These pink slimes are probably just not necessary, are they? So we're gonna purchase the coop and immediately get the high wall upgrade for it. Now, did I even get the high wall upgrade back at the other? Maybe not, maybe not. So this high wall hopefully will be high enough. So stony hens, you guys go out here, and a roostro, and let's see if the pink slimes can figure out how to jump inside. Hopefully not. And I wanna go ahead and buy the upgrades while we're here. The spring grass and the Vitamizer. So there goes all of our money again, but I wanna make sure that we have this place well stocked with meat because we've got so many meat eaters now. And while I'm upgrading things, why not try upgrading a garden? We have not done any garden upgrades, I don't think, except maybe nutrient soil one time. So let's try a sprinkler to make the crops grow twice as fast. That's a lovely little sprinkler there, isn't it? Shooting what looks like snow. It's a snow machine. And we can add to scare slime if we really needed to. That's probably better for the expansion. Remove crops you can now buy for 10 coins to plant something completely new. That makes sense, and it's fairly cheap. And nutrient soil, of course, is going to increase the yield to maximum every time. So let's do all those things. With little crystals buried into the soil, we now have a fully upgraded garden. I think it's time we tackle one of my side objectives, and that is start accruing enough fruits to feed to the giant phosphor slime. Because they do love their fruits, they're trying to eat them right out from under me, aren't they? I think I vacuumed one up before it could even make any plorts. But to get more fruit, we probably need to start upgrading these plots as well, don't we? We don't really have enough money for that, unfortunately, but I think 12 is a decent start, and we've got some more fruits back in storage. Do you guys remember how much pogo fruit we got stashed in here? We haven't used this in forever. 64 is pretty solid. That's two full trips now that we can carry 30 fruit per slot. Two more and we're good to go. Out into the night. I don't think we need any more phosphor slimes though, just the big one. And I believe all we have to do is just take a little trip over this edge. Wait, where is this? Hold on, we haven't been over here before. I thought this is how you get the shortcut over to the cave. I don't think I've been over here yet. There's a ramp leading this direction, but to where? Is it just loops back around? Oh, this is a new area? Hold on, hold your horses. Can we get over there? I think I see trees with can we jetpack over there? No, that is the bridge. There's a bridge leading over there. That's where the giant pink slime was. Maybe we can get on top of the arch. I'm gonna come back here later. There's gotta be a reason for all this being here. There's heartbeats hanging out on top. Old heartbeats at that. I'll take some extra veggies to feed the Phosphor Queen. I jumped the ledge way too soon before, didn't I? This is the ledge I was thinking of to jump over, and there's a happy Phosphor Gordo who now has a diet of fruit. Remember last time it didn't say what they wanted to eat before, and now it does? Okay, whatever. It works now, that's all that matters. So have 30 Poco Fruits. How many can you feast upon? I want to think it's growing. It's got to be getting bigger, right? And you love Q-berries, I know, but that's not enough. Is it really? There's a hidden box here. Maybe we'll find a few more fruits inside the box. Or a Roostro. There's one Q-berry. That would make 10 Q-berries. I was hoping the 10th one would be enough. I guess it was just too much to hope for. All right, I'll go get some more, Your Holiness. Time to get that secondary supply of fruit. Got here just in time. The tree completely disappeared. So that's when you know it's time to replant. So it's a lot more communicative now to the player. Lets you know really handily when you need to actually plant another fruit or veggie. In this case, we got another Q-berry tree gone. So let's just use one each for both stations and then gather the remainder of our pogo fruits set back out for one more feeding for Queen Phosphor Slime herself. We can only hope that this is enough to sate her desire. The Gordos eat until they can eat no longer. There we go. We had just enough. You've blessed me with a box and a key. I don't know if we can use this key, but we're gonna find out, won't we? Maybe this is just an alternative key. Maybe this key works in case you don't find the pink one, or maybe it's a key for a currently unavailable location. I think that's a very real possibility. Okay, we're about to have a problem here because we're gonna create our own tar slime by accident if we're not careful. I gotta keep this box away from them so they don't eat whatever is inside of it. In this case, just a simple carrot. Well, I unlocked the mystery at least. We're gonna be Slime Rancher completionists, so we had to collect all the keys, even if they don't do anything for us yet. It looks like we can cross another goal off the list. I still need to find a golden slime and figure out what to do with it. And there's one more jumbo slime left to unlock. There might still be a hidden area left. I know there's still a lot of question marks in the Slimepedia, but those slimes and other resources may be locked behind, walled off in development areas. We'll see. Maybe we can find some of those hidden resources then. Join me next time in Slime Rancher. Thank you guys so much for watching, and I'll see you next time.